The University of Michigan is taking a leading role in research to fight dental caries, or cavities, one of the most common chronic diseases facing young children in the U.S. today. Dr. Margherita Fontana, a professor in the Department of Cariology, Restorative Sciences, and Endodontics at the University of Michigan, is leading a team of researchers from several universities across the country in a $9.6 million grant-funded clinical trial to test the effectiveness of silver diamine fluoride, or SDF, in arresting caries in children.
The product is very cheap. And the treatment procedure is very cheap. You don't have to anesthetize the child, and therefore it's very fast. And overall, the expense then is very low. This obviously improves access to the population in general.
The National Institute of Dental and Craniofacial Research is funding the study. Today, about 23% of children between the ages of 2 and 5 have cavities. The impact to kids between 6 and 8 years old jumps to nearly 50%. Children living in low socioeconomic or minority populations face an even higher risk. Increased access to sugary foods and drinks and the lack of access to proper dental care plays a role in dental caries in young children. Once a family is referred to the study, a team member contacts the parent or legal guardian with an invitation to participate and to ask a series of screening questions to ensure that their child qualifies.
Hi, this is Meredith from the Michigan SDF study. How are you doing today?
Then, the child is examined by a dentist who is trained and calibrated for the study. The dentist checks to be sure that the child has teeth with cavities that comply with the inclusion criteria for the SDF trial.
And if that's the case, then additional questionnaires are completed, and then the child gets randomized to one of the two treatments, the active treatment and a placebo.
The process of actually applying the drug is really quite simple and painless. The tooth is brushed and then wiped dry. Then the SDF is brushed onto the tooth for 10 seconds.
Good job.
That is so good.
One, two, three.
And then the families are contacted and seen 24 hours after that to ensure that there's no concerns or no issues with the treatment. And then about every month, we talk to the parent to ensure that there's no concerns as well. And about every 2 to 3 months, we see the child in person. And about 6 months after the initial treatment, we'll repeat treatment again. And at 8 months, the trial participation ends.
For young children, the use of SDF is much preferred over the more traditional treatment for cavities. Fontana says her team will consider many factors along the way.
Because if a child is not having pain, they're sleeping at night, they're eating better, they're not missing school, the parent is not missing work. So there's a lot of quality metrics for the family and for the individual that you can measure outside of the mouth itself.
The goal is to obtain a cavity arrest drug claim in the U.S. SDF is not completely new to the U.S. It was approved in 2014 to arrest dental hypersensitivity. Phase 3 of this 4-year trial is currently underway and will follow more than 1,000 children before the study ends.